Hi, today I'm going to tell you about Multiflora rose, which is a perennial shrub that's invasive to our Lower Hudson PRISM region. It was introduced to the United States in the late 1800s as rootstock for cultivated roses, but has now escaped that cultivation and is now starting to impact a lot of our forest ecosystems and the understory of our native forests. So as you can see, there's a couple of distinguishing features of it. It's got these like curved, arched branches to it and a ton of thorns on it, which make it really difficult to remove from your own property or along the trails. It was planted in the mid-1900s for barrier fences along for livestock. It was also for erosion control, but now that has escaped is really starting to outcompete a lot of the native plants that we're trying to protect. So I'm going to show you a couple of details of the key ID features that will distinguish it from some of the other native lookalikes and other invasive shrubs in our region. Sometimes it's hard to tell what is what in this big thorny mess on our properties and along the trail system. So let's take a look at some of the key identifying features that distinguish Multiflora rose from some of the other invasive shrubs and even our native shrubs. So if we take a look and zoom in here, one of the key features are these berries. So the berries of Multiflora rose are oblong shaped and they're persistent. They may even last throughout the winter. We're filming right now in mid-April, and you can see that the berries are actually still on it. They're eaten by birds and can even mammals and can be dispersed far and wide. Here's a look at two of its main key features. If you take a look right to the right of my thumb, you can obviously see the thorns of this, and it's really curved backwards, almost like the dorsal fin of a shark is the way I like to think of it. And then if you see just to up above and to the right of my thumb are what are called these fringe stipules. They almost look like a little caterpillar or something at the base of these, at the base of the leaf stalks as it touches the branch. Well, Carolina roses and swamp roses and some of our native roses do not have that little fringe or hairy stipules, they're called. So that's definitely one of the key identifying features of Multiflora rose and how it's distinguished from some of the others. Multiflora rose also has a compound leaf. And so that means that the leaf itself is divided into leaflets, and they can be anywhere from 6 to 8 leaflets on it. And as you can see in this example that I have here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But again, that can vary. But basically the leaflets are toothed, as you can see here. And again, looking for that fringe stipule as it attaches to the branch at the base of the leaf stalk. Here's a lookalike alert. This is Japanese barberry that I have here, and one of the distinguishing features of Japanese barberry are these spoon-shaped leaves, which are very different than the compound toothed leaves of Multiflora rose. And actually, if I look over here, you can see why it can be confused. I mean, it does have thorns, and you can see the persistent berries as well. But take a look at the thorns there. You see how they're much straighter? You don't have that dorsal fin shark look to it. So, barberry thorns are much straighter, almost toothpick shape to it. Even though you can still see berries on it, Multiflora rose doesn't have those spoon-shaped leaves of barberry. So that's just another way to tell it apart, even though they'll both prick you if you're out in the woods.